during medical school, as I went through the different rotations, I liked the flow of the work, you know, in that this was more focused on trying to figure out what was the problem, the abnormality. When I look at a scan, there's a finite amount of time that I consider it for the most part, and then I generate a report. I am a neuroradiologist, so I primarily spend the bulk of my day looking at scans, CAT scans and MRIs of the brain, spine, and head and neck. And I've done this for the last 20 years. I think I'm very good and very efficient at doing this, and especially with the difficult, complex cases that we see at the Cleveland Clinic. And the Cleveland Clinic is it's a wonderful institution in a lot of ways. In northeastern Ohio, we have, you know, 60 MRI scanners, which is more than the number of MRI scanners in some countries, believe it or not. So in our fellowship program, we're able to take doctors who've trained from whatever sort of program, whether it's a high-level university-based program or a small community-based program, and then within a year's time, give them enough exposure and guidance so that they become a good neuroradiologist. This is one of the few places where if you come in, you get enough depth and breadth of training so that you can go into whatever sort of practice that you want. You are ready to go to a job where you read a ton of studies, but they may not be of very high complexity, or you may wind up going to an academic job at a university or big tertiary medical center such as here. And I think that's a very unique point of both the residency here and the fellowship that we have. It's genuinely a nice place to work. It's genuinely a nice place to sort of sit down and talk with other people in between cases. And I think that's something that's overlooked. The time you spend actually doing medicine when you're in the hospital is a big fraction, but that's not everything. All the interstitial time when you interact with other people. I think when you interact with pleasant people who have the patient's welfare in mind, I think it makes all the difference.